Hello, happy Sabbath. My name is Lawrence, and in this video, I will be summarizing this week's lesson. But before we get started, subscribe to this channel and share this video. When you subscribe and share, you support our dreams of building church houses in your country. Now, let's get started. This week we are studying lesson 8, Choose Life. And the memory text reads, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life, that both you and your descendants may live. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. So this week, we are going to look at the chance God gives us to choose life. So the Sunday's lesson talks about the tree of life, and we learn that none of us chose to be in existence, or chose where and when we were born. We did not have this choice. The same can be said about Adam and Eve. They did not choose for God to make them, but God gave us life anyway. But the good news is, God offers us a choice about the life He gives us. We can choose to have everlasting life in Him through Jesus. In Genesis 2 verse 8, God gives Adam two choices about life: to choose to obey God and have access to the tree of life, or to disobey God and die. In the end, Adam sinned and lost access to the tree of life. But interestingly, we see that the tree of life that appears in Genesis also appears in Revelation. According to the lesson, God wants us to remember that we always were meant to eat from the tree of life, but we lost that blessing because of sin. After God solves the problem of sin, we will eat from this tree again, but first, we must choose life. Now, the Monday's lesson talks about no middle ground. All through the Bible, God gives us two choices, life or death. Read John chapter 3 verse 16, Genesis 7 verse 22, Romans 6 verse 23 about the two choices we are presented with. But remember, we are part of the great controversy between good and evil. And before this ends, each one of us will have made a personal choice for life or death. We can choose everlasting life or death. Paul says in 2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 9 that those who choose death will be destroyed forever. What choice will you make? Tuesday's lesson, life and good, death and evil, blessings and curses. In this lesson, we learn that the Lord put one of two choices before His people. This was same with Adam and Eve. They had one of two choices in Eden. How do we know this? The Hebrew word for good, tav, and for evil, Ra, in Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 15 are the same Hebrew words used in Genesis when Moses talked about the tree of knowledge of good, tav, and evil, Ra. So we see that Adam and Eve had only one of two choices. The choice is the same for us too. We can choose life, good, blessing, or we can choose death, evil, and curses. Also, we learn in this lesson what is called free will or free choice. So in Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 15 to 20, the Lord is really saying to His people that I have given you free choice. Choose life and not death. Wednesday's lesson, not too hard for you. Deuteronomy chapter 30 verses 1 to 10 reveals that God will show His people love when they turn back to Him. Also, in Deuteronomy chapter 30 verses 11 to 14, we see that the Lord does not ask His people to do anything too difficult. He says, this command that I give you today is not too hard for you. The word is very near to you. It is in your mouth and in your heart, so you can obey it. So here, the Lord is saying that you know my commandments well enough, so there is no excuse for not obeying me. After the Lord gives the people His command, they are told to choose between life and death. Thursday's lesson, a question of worship. What made Israel different from the people around them? The answer is worship. Worship is one of the most important parts of the agreement between God and His people. Only Israel worshiped the Lord. The people around them worshiped false gods. So in Deuteronomy chapter 4 verse 19, we see a common warning of worship. So God wants you to worship only Him. Again, we see in this lesson that we must make a choice. we must choose to worship the Lord or choose to worship other gods and get evil, curses, and death. God did not force his people to follow him, and God will not force us today. Read the Friday's lesson for further thought. Thanks for watching.